at Great Falls National Park in Virginia. It's December 22nd. It's my Christmas long weekend. It rained heavily last night, but today it is so clear with bright blue skies. So a little about Great Falls. This is a very small national park situated along the Potomac River. This is the fourth largest river along the Atlantic coast. The river marks the boundary between Virginia and Maryland. I'm currently standing on the Virginia side and the opposite border belongs to Maryland. So at Great Falls, the river drops 16 feet in just a mile, and that is why we have this dramatic life landscape here with all the rocky bed. It was so, so beautiful here. So according to the NPS website, the rocks here are about 550 million old and formed from sandstones and mudstones. The dense and erosion resistant metamorphic rock is why we have the falls, and further on we have the Mather Gorge. This landscape has not changed much. It is said that the views that George Washington saw are identical to the one that I'm seeing now. Pretty incredible, right? So that's how hard the rock here is. So this area is also historically significant. George Washington wanted a nation who was linked by direct trade routes, and that is why he wanted to harness the Potomac River for transportation. Unfortunately, the Potomac River has several rapids because of its rocky bed, and that is why they dug a canal along the river known as the Potomac Canal, and they used this for transportation in the 19th century. Now we can see just the remnants of the Potomac Canal along this trail that I'm doing today. Also, because of the narrow gorge, this area is prone to flooding. And here they have this post marking how high the waters were in some of the biggest floods throughout time. So I think the highest level was in the year 1936. So you can see by this post how high that water is. So remember that this is already approximately 30 feet high from the riverbed. So imagine the flood water in 1936, right? The complete trail was along the Potomac River, and as you can see here, the trail is kind of like rocky, but they did a nice trail. So here you can see the potholes formed because of the water. So at one point millions of years ago, all of this area was under the sea. River. So it is said that the last ice age did not reach this south, but you could see the effects of the extreme cold on this landscape. So I'm sure like geologists would know better, but that's what one of the boards said, that you can see evidence of the extreme cold that was there. So from this point, you can see the Mather Gorge. Mather Gorge is just like, you know, the chasm formed by this Potomac River. So jevade pan light rocks hote, the river eroded through them, but all the resistant rock are remaining, forming the high cliffs. So see here, you can see the height of the top of the cliffs right now. So it's all at approximately like 20 to 30 feet in several areas. There are areas along the trail where I will go to the river level. But for the most part, we are approximately 20 to 30 feet high from the river surface. In terms of hike, I think this is one of my worst hikes because I stopped at so many times. The river was really enticing. Every clearing that I could see, I had to stop, and I could literally stay there the whole day watching at the river. It was so mesmerizing. Really, really loved the scenery here. There's something about flowing water that attracts me so much. And most human beings, I think. I'm doing a tiny bit of rock climbing, or not even that, but I saw along my route there were several professional rock climbers. Like I said, the height is it's quite high. That will give several rock climbers the thrill of their lifetime. The trail obviously is very well maintained because it's a national park. When I went, we were in the middle of the government shutdown, so there were no park rangers, and some of the routes were actually closed. That didn't stop people from using those trails. And I think this was one of those sections where it was supposed to be closed, but people were just walking, and so did I. डिसेंबरमध्ये गेले असले तरी देर वर सो मेनी पीपल देअर, एस्पेशली इन दी मेन फॉल्स एरिया. सो नाऊ वी आर अहेड ऑफ दी फॉल्स. इट्स नॉट अ ह्यूज फॉल्स एज लाईक हाईटमध्ये तो काय फॉल्स खूप मोठे नाही आहेत, बट दे स्टील कॉल इट फॉल्स. बट वी आर पास्ट दॅट मेन टुरिस्टी सेक्शन. सो इन दॅट सेक्शन देर वर सो मेनी पीपल. Actual trail mein the trail continues on to a high point, I think. There were not that many people there, but there were people running there. So yeah, section mein you can see that I have dropped height a lot, and I'm very close to the actual river surface. I'm not sure how deep this river is. There was no board or anything telling me how deep it was. But based on the flow, it should not be that deep. But who knows? I mean, and as you can see from this point on, the trail becomes a little bit, rugged. आतापर्यंतची ट्रेल वॉज क्वाईट वाईड अँड क्वाईट फ्लॅट. सो फ्रॉम दिस पॉईंट ऑन द ट्रेल बिकम्स अन ॲक्च्युअल हायकिंग ट्रेल विथ सम एलिव्हेशन गेन, नॉट टू मच बट इनफ टू इन्क्रीज युअर हार्ट रेट अ लिटल बिट. So here I'm leaving you with a poem. It's called The River of Life, and the poem goes like this. You have witnessed nature's beauty, a monumental feat, an ever-changing landscape that's never complete. The ever-changing rivers and ever-shifting sands have brought forth many islands and sunken many islands. It's all about the process, this constant ebb and flow, that many watch with little thought, but only God does know. Poetry in motion in all its many forms, a performance still in progress through sunny days or storms. I felt that this poem was very applicable for this Great Falls. So that's it. On to my next adventure. Bye.